We have studied till line number 209 in this particular scene, and what we have found this, the change in attitude in Portia, in Bassanio, as well as we have found a new story in this particular drama, that is the affair between Nerissa and Graciano. So Nerissa and Graciano in fear, we have got Bassanio. And Portia in pair, we have got Lorenzo and Jessica in pair, and we have got Antonio and his sadness in his pair. That's all. And in this particular scene, if we look from beginning, we'll make a synopsis. How we'll complete these scenes? First, we'll make a synopsis of this one. We'll divide this one into several units. We'll discuss the allusions, and finally we'll discuss the important lines. So what we have found at the beginning of the scene, Portia stopping Bassanio to choose immediately. She wants his company for a few more days. Later, what we have discovered, we have found Bassanio wants to play the game of casket as soon as possible. Every time a question occurs, that is why. Because he does not want to extend the duration of this tension. Since a longer settlement in Belmont will put Bassanio into lot more tension. He will be worried about the future. Same will be the case with Portia, that Portia did not understand clearly. Later on, we found that Bassanio's choice is going to be musical. Later on, he was hinted with a song, and he delivered his famous speech that brings out the distinction between appearance and reality, as well tells us the difference between outward beauty and inward qualities. He raises the example of legal system, legislature, as well as religion, and obviously beauty. And finally, he chose the gold, that linen casket, rejecting gold and silver. And more than that, after winning the game of casket, he found it a totally different world. It was hard for him to believe that situation, to accept the fact that he had really won the game of casket. Portia later validated him that he really performed well in the game of casket. And further, if you look at this particular drama, what will you find? That Portia will also express her gratitude to the goddess of luck. She says that she is ready. She said that she was ready to change herself, to be governed by Bassanio, to learn from Bassanio, and she was ready to hand over everything that she has, to submit herself into the service of Bassanio. And at the end, Graciano unfolded the desire he had inside his heart. So as Nerissa, that they both were in an affair. They both loved each other. So they were also ready to get married. And Bassanio certified them that they could also get married when Portia would get married to him. So their marriage ceremony is going to be a great one, going to be a ceremonial one, going to be a matter of great festival. But such thing will not happen. Why, we'll read later. But this is the short summary of this particular part. Now we'll divide this one into units, clear? And after dividing these things into units, we'll read this one properly. So this is the first one, that is the summary. Now the first unit deals with Bassanio's presence in Belmont, where Portia tells him to tarry, to wait for a few more days. It does not mean she loves her, neither she hates her, but we know very well the fact is she is really in love with him. Secondary thing is that She is afraid of the game of casket as well as luck. She does not know whom she will get as life partner. So she thought it was better of her to accept Bassanio as her life partner. And she told him that a maiden could not express her feelings directly, since it would look very awkward and very weird. So she decided not to unfold directly. On the other hand, Bassanio was not ready to play the game of casket later. He wanted to play that one immediately. Portia mentioned clearly that half of her, that means whatever belongs to her, is now handed over to Bassanio. Half of her feelings, half of her property and everything will go to Bassanio, and remaining half will be with her. And since she herself is in love with Bassanio, so that remaining half also belongs to Bassanio. So she is solely attached to Bassanio. Bassanio rejected that proposal of staying there further, mentioning that he would be in great tension. But Portia did not like that at all. Bassanio used the term rack that hurt Portia a great deal. Later on, he explained the matter, and they had a role play as executioner and as a convict. Bassanio as convict, Portia as executioner. And finally Bassanio confessed very privately that he had a great deal of love for her, which Portia accepted and allowed him to play the game of casket. This is unit 1. In second unit, what we have found that Bassanio was helped. First of all, her selection is going to be musical, that was confirmed by Portia. And what happened? That if he wins, there will be a fanfare. The music will be a ceremonial one, and if he loses, the music will be a sad one, just like the death of a swan. Or if he wins, the music will be a very festival, full of festivity. That means when the music is played, when the king is newly coronated or elected, just like the king receives the salutes from the people, common people, or just like the music that is played on the day of marriage. So this type of music will be played if Bassanio wins. Later on, the song was played when he elected the casket, that was rhythmically moving to lead, just like tell me where the fancy bread, in the heart or in the head. Obviously the rhyme moves to lead. Similarly, if you look, it is said that love, if it is visual, it is born in our eyes. And if it is visual, with the course of age, the beauty dies. So the love also dies in our eyes. So we should not love anyone with using our eyes. So that was the part. And Bassanio, being intelligent, immediately understood what was conveyed. So he said that the outward shows the least themselves. Still the world is deceived with ornaments. That means we should not believe in outward beauty. He talks about legal system. Then he talks about Hercules, he talks about Mars, he talks about strength, that people increase the length of their beard in order to show that they are very brave and strong, but they are chicken hearted people. Same is the case with beauty. People use makeup, people use wigs to make themselves more beautiful, but actually they are not. And saying all these things, he took the reference of allusion of Midas, who had the blessings that whatever you touch will get transformed into gold. And he suffered. His food got transformed into gold. He could not eat also. So he ultimately believed, he ultimately confirmed that his selection is going to be lit. And ultimately joy was the consequence. He won the game. That was the unit 2. And in unit 3, what you have seen after the triumph, he described the portrait of Portia in a hyperbolic way, saying that this portrait is the creation of someone who is like a god. Later on, he got a scroll that informed him, authenticated him to be the owner of Portia's property and the husband of Portia. Further, Portia and Bassanio had a very confusing time. It was hard for Bassanio to believe that he had really won the game of casket. But Portia validated him that he had really done so. Portia also found that she was treble beautiful. He was 3 times more, 100 times more beautiful, more rich, only because of the presence or arrival of Bassanio. And that's all. And she was ready to change herself. She was ready to be governed by Bassanio. She was ready to be taught by Bassanio. So all these things we have discovered in this part. And finally, that was unit 4, what we have found, where Graciano unfolded her love for Nerissa. So as Nerissa unfolded her love, and they were ready to get married, and their marriage would be done at the same day, at the same venue, along with Bassanio's marriage. So these are the 4 units that we have here. Now allusion, what we have here, we have allusion of Hesione here, and we have allusion of Hercules here, and further we have the allusion of Midas. These are the allusions we have here. So what is this allusion here? Once, what happened? A sea monster attacked Troy in order to get all the horses. The Trojan king was not at all ready to hand over the horses. And ultimately the monster took the princess. All the Trojan wives were crying. All were just waiting for the arrival of Hercules. Ultimately Hercules arrived and saved Hesione, rescued Hesione from that monster. Here the same condition, we have metaphorically the same condition of Portia. What happens? She is a sacrificial figure. Her father has left her in the hands of luck. So she is sacrificed, she is tributed to the hands of luck, to the game of casket. No one knows who will win Portia, a mad, a drunkard, an egoist, or a gentleman. So a tremendous fight. All were waiting to see whether Portia will survive or not. And ultimately what happened? Bassanio came in rescue. He played the game of casket, took the risk, fought bravely, and ultimately selected the correct one. The way Hesione was saved by Hercules, the young Alcides. He fought the battle. And here all the people who are standing aside to see the selection of Bassanio are just like the people who are standing to see the fight at the seashore of Troy. So it's just same thing we have got here. Okay. And further we have got the allusion of Midas. Midas, already I told you one allusion that Midas had the donkey's ear. That was another story. And later on Midas was blessed that whatever you touch would get transformed into gold. He touched his palace, it got transformed into gold. His wife got transformed into gold. His daughter got transformed into gold. Even everything got transformed into gold. Unfortunately, when he touched his food, that got transformed into gold. No one can eat gold. So Bassanio wanted to say that gold does have only outward beauty. You cannot feed upon gold. So that was mentioned clearly there. And these are the 2 allusions we have here till line number 211. So this is the second thing that we have got here, and these are the important lines. If we take one thing, I would like to tell you, each and every line is important here. Even I would like to tell you, if you want to get the exact important lines here. The song hinting Bassanio while selecting the casket, that is very important, as well as the template, as well as the writing on the scroll is very important. That writing starts with you that choose not by view, chance as fear, and choose as true. That is very important. Which lines are important? First, I would like to tell you that line number 1, 2, 3, 4, very important. That is very important. Line number 1, 2, 3, 4. And we should also pay attention to line number 18, 19, and 20. Further, we should pay attention to line number 37 to 41, and obviously that part which talks about music, that is important. We should read that entire episode related to Alcides and Hesione and the sea monster. Further, we should read that Bassanio's speech, especially that part from line number 75 to line number 11109. These are very important. Then what is important? That Bassanio's speech regarding the portrait of Portia, that is 118 onwards to line number 130. Then obviously you have to go through the line, line number 160 to 170, further from 170 to 175, and then we have to be careful of the line 192 to 197. These are important. And further, if we look at, I think, this Graciano speech, line number 199 to line number 210, these are very important. So be careful and go through these things. Finding doubt, you must obviously ask me. Okay, thank you very much.